Oh, hello. My name is Mara, and welcome to Books Like Woe. So, I've got a quick video for you guys today. It is April, and we all know that April begins with April Fools, aka a time to torture other people in the name of humor, and you can tell maybe by that comment that I don't really like pranks. I don't like things where I feel like you're making somebody the victim to get a laugh. That's just my opinion. But anyway, side note, the worst kinds of people in the entire world to me are people without a sense of humor. There's no greater gift in this world than laughter. So all that to say, it made me think about books that make me laugh. And I actually find this to be kind of a hard category to think about because I do think that it's somewhat difficult to have a book that is universally funny. But I did come up with some titles that I remember when I was reading them distinctly laughing out loud. Like that was my criteria, is did it ever make me actually laugh out loud? And I did come up with a good list here. I have noticed from this that I definitely lean towards a more British sense of humor is what can make me laugh out loud in books. I mean, I like that in general, like that kind of dry or like absurdist thing that the UK is kind of known for with its humor. I definitely found that when I was picking my books. So anyway, this is just a quick list of books that made me laugh, and hopefully something in here might make you laugh. Anyway, let's get into it. So first, let's start with like the one that actually is the one that makes me laugh the most, and that is P.G. Wodehouse. This is the best of Wodehouse. Here's a sampling in here. He's best known for Jeeves and Wooster, and if you have seen the adaptation with Stephen Fry and Hugh Laurie, that is also hilarious. These books are just so funny. The short stories are great. That's actually my favorite from him. They're just absolutely absurd, filled with dumb people doing dumb things. I just really love it. I think one of my very favorites from him is a short story about like them taking bets as to who could stay awake longest during a sermon. Anyway, these are just like, it's light, frivolous nonsense set during kind of like the height of the beautiful young things, and it's a lot of fun. Next is an entire series from Jonathan Howard, which is Johannes Cabal. I particularly like Johannes Cabal the detective. Again, just very like dry humor, very witty, very kind of absurdist, and there's a particular line in here, I don't know if I'll be able to find it, but basically he describes this woman's night robe as making him wonder how the British had ever found sufficient motivation to breed, and just something about that made me laugh so hard when he was describing this little nightgown. So anyway, this series makes me laugh. This book in particular made me laugh a lot. Next, we've got Harry Potter and J.K. Rowling in general. I have to say, I think the thing that makes these books kind of like stand up over time for me, it's not just like the thematic content, which of course is great. A lot of it is the humor. I love her sense of humor. I think she has a very kind of good perspective on some of the absurdities of life, and also just finds ways to kind of sneak in sly little nods to nonsense, and I appreciate that. But these books make me laugh out loud when I'm reading them, even now. So I, you know, gotta give it to her. She's been making me laugh for like 20 years or whatever it is. Okay, next is, I wanted to try to find something nonfiction, and you know, I guess for this I probably should have gone with something like David Foster Wallace essays, because those do make me laugh. But I didn't do that. I picked a book that I already have, and that is How Not to Write a Novel, 200 Classic Mistakes and How to Avoid Them, A Misstep by Misstep Guide. I like this just because it's so cranky, and I kind of enjoy, I enjoy sort of cranky humor, and it reminds me of like when I'm writing an email at work trying not to be angry, or like trying not to be a complete asshole to people, being like, as referenced 300 times previously in other emails, see all attached, you cannot do X, Y, and Z. Like, it kind of reminds me a little bit of that tone, and I enjoyed sort of the flusteriness of this. Okay, then we've got, maybe this was not a British person, I don't know, but another, back to the Brits. We've got Oscar Wilde next. I love Oscar Wilde. I think I've loved pretty much everything I've ever read from him, but in particular, I was thinking of The Importance of Being Earnest. I just think that's just a classic comedic play that's a lot of fun, and just so, I think, taking the piss out of people in a great way. I think the quote from this that always I quote frequently is, ignorance is like a rare exotic fruit. Touch it and the bloom is gone. Thankfully, the education in the UK has had no influence whatsoever on the lower classes or something like that. That was Lady Bracknell. Anyway, this is great fun. It's a lot of nonsense. Oscar Wilde in general has a lot of humor, but I particularly like that play. Okay, so I think we're out of Britain now. So two series, both of which make me laugh for similar reason, and that is banter. I've mentioned this before, but I love banter between two like cops or two like friends, whatever. One series I think that does this really well is the Kate Daniel series by Ilona Andrews. She has great banter with Andrea. She has great banter with Curran. She's a banter machine, and I appreciate that. And then the other one I was thinking of was In Death by J.D. Robb. I mention that all the time, but yeah, Peabody and Dallas have great chemistry, and I love watching them kind of verbally spar. One very specific author, I mentioned this in my romance month, that this author makes me laugh, and she showed up a lot on that list, on the various lists I did because of that, and that is Jessica Clare / Jessica Sims / Jill Miles. She's not a great writer. I'm not saying she is, but I find her work very entertaining, and a large part of that is that she always has an eye at the fourth wall. She's not taking things too seriously, and it's a romance novel. Why would you? I think she fully embraces the comedic vein of the romance, romantic comedy. Like, I think she fully embraces that in a way that is fun. So she always makes me laugh, so I thought I'd put her on here. And then the last one I had written down, I was trying to think of another kind of like nonfiction or memoir type thing, and the obvious person on here might be someone like David Sedaris, who I actually don't really like that much. I know, I'm sorry. He doesn't really make me laugh. I enjoy listening to him on This American Life, but he doesn't necessarily make me laugh. I just like him. The memoir that made me laugh out loud was Bossy Pants. Now, I'm not sure how it would hold up. I'd be interested to listen to it again, because I did listen to that on audio. But at the time, it definitely made me laugh a lot. So there's a thought for a memoir. Oh, and actually, sorry, I'm just fucking up all over the place. The last one I want to mention, again, back to the UK, and this one, one of the books that's made me laugh the hardest, is The Secret Diary of Adrian Mole by, I believe, Sue Townsend. Oh my God, like, this kid is just, it's the diary of, I think he's like 13-ish, and he is just so full of pomposity. I wish that I was British so I'd fully understand how funny this book is, because there's so many like cultural references that I know I don't fully get. It was written during like Thatcherite era, but it you don't even have to get all the references for it to be so funny, because it's just like, it reminds you of the pomposity of youth and just sort of like your own self-importance at that age, and like how you're such an idiot and you don't even realize it, and if someone were to read your diary from that time period, like, it would be bad. Anyway, that is a very, very funny book, and I can't believe I almost forgot to mention it. And actually, I just realized I didn't put her on this list, but Jane Austen would also definitely qualify. I mean, someone like Mr. Collins, I definitely laughed out loud when I was reading that for the first time, and what a boob, right? Like, she has very specific characters that I think do a good job of like being very impactful regarding humor. So she makes me laugh. Bonus recommendation, Jane Austen. So yeah, that was really pretty much all the books I could think of. Like I said, I do think that humor is a wonderful thing in books, and it's something I really appreciate when I find it, and like, I'm a very loyal reader if I find an author who can make me laugh, but it is kind of hard to make me laugh in books. I don't know, are you the same way? Let me know. So yeah, if you have other suggestions for books that might make me laugh or books that made you laugh, definitely let me know in the comments below. But yeah, I think that will do it. If you enjoyed this video, please like, subscribe, follow me on the social medias if you are so inclined. I have all that information listed in the description box below, and I think that will do it. I hope you guys are having a great day, and I will talk to you soon. Bye!